And in the dating scene, you may have heard the term catfishing lately. The recent controversy surrounding Notre Dame football star and his girlfriend, who never existed, has put online dating scams back in the spotlight. And who better to shed some light on scams than our own Susan Hogan? She joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thanks for being here today.
Sure.
Dating scams are not anything new, right? This has been going on for a long time.
Honestly, for as long as there have been single men and women,
yes.
It's been going on.
Right.
But obviously with social media, it certainly does make it a little bit more out there.
And tell us what catfishing is, because a lot of people may not even, you know, they've heard the term once
right.
or twice, and of course recently they heard it.
Sure.
But even still, it's somewhat confusing what it actually is.
It is. Catfishing is very similar to phishing scams. But with catfishing, it's when the scammer takes on an entirely new identity. So a fake name, fake profile pictures. He's stealing them off of Facebook, also fake profiles. And it's really to lure you in using this entirely fake persona of this particular person. And just like fishing, though, is to get you to suck you in and then to spit you out.
And there's nothing, is there anything anybody can do to even protect ourselves from not getting in this scam? I mean, because this guy, the football player first, was calling this other person his girlfriend, who he never met.
Exactly. Well, here's the deal. When you're dealing with these scammers and with this catfishing or sweetheart scams, as they're also called, they take a while. So these scammers will go on dating websites. They'll go on a lot of other social websites as well. And with these, it could take weeks to months, but they slowly send out emails to people. To mostly women are the ones who usually are the ones who get scammed. And as I said, they kind of slowly bring you in, and starting slowly with the emails, gaining your trust. And once they feel they've got you, then they're going to get you, and they get you hard too.
And as you were saying, people are they're looking for that someone special. They're mm-hmm. looking for love. What can we look out for? What are the red flags that we really need to keep an eye out for?
Okay, there are a lot of red flags, certainly. If the person that you've just met online all of a sudden says to you, let's go to a private email, be a little skeptical. It doesn't mean that that's a bad thing. It just is a red flag. Just kind of think about that. Also, if they proclaim instant love for you, I mean, really, seriously.
It could happen.
Well,
look at me.
Okay. Well, in your case. But honestly, if they're proclaiming love instantly, you really want to step back. A lot of things with dating scams, you've got to use your gut. You know, I know that people are vulnerable, and you
sure.
want to truly believe what you're reading. You want to truly believe that this person that you're talking to, that you're emailing with, truly loves you and is developing feelings for you. While that may be the case, I mean, you got to just kind of always be skeptical. And also the other thing, too, is if they're telling you that they want to see you, and, you know, I'm dying to see you, and they build that up, and they finally say, I'm going to come and see you, and then suddenly pull the plug because of some horrible, tragic event, then get ready, because the money request is to follow
okay.
because of these horrible events.
And one of the other things you were saying, military, mm-hmm. military people are really vulnerable for this.
Well, yes and no. When we say military people, unfortunately, they've been used as pawns for this scheme, okay?
Right.
So these scammers have been going off on websites, Facebook websites, finding military personnel, using their pictures, usually those guys dressed in fatigues.
Sure.
Putting them, I mean, my goodness, you're a woman at home,
right.
and you're vulnerable,
right.
and you see this military man, and, you know, he's in Afghanistan or wherever he may be, and, you know, he talks about his, you know, being away from home,
right.
and you develop this relationship with this soldier. Well, I have done a couple of these scams where women that we've spoken to in interview have actually fallen for the same man. This picture of this one soldier has been used thousands of times. But, you know, we wouldn't know that as
right.
if we were on these dating
sure.
websites. And lo and behold, when, you know, the scammer would, you know, reach out to you. And then once you Google this guy's name, you realize, first of all, it wasn't the real soldier.
Right.
And the name was used for different kinds of scams, all for trying to proclaim their love and to get people's money. And women have sent thousands and thousands of dollars. The one story that we did on this one woman who was in Jamestown, she sent probably over $4,000 because they suck
they
you
just
in
want
and
that.
They really
yeah.
want you to believe that they're there for you. But again, when you're doing these dating websites, you just use common sense. Right. Stop and really take a big deep breath and say, is this really happening?
Okay. All right. Sounds good. So daters, beware.
Yep.
Thanks so much for all the information. And you can see all of Susan's consumer tips right on our website, WPRI.com.